Hey guys, this is Austin, and today I'm here with a tutorial on how to set up and activate the iPhone 5. The first step is to get yourself a Nano SIM, not a micro SIM like previous iPhones have used. Your iPhone may have come with this, but if not, get one from your carrier. Depending on the model, you might get a SIM eject tool, but if not, a bent paperclip will work just fine. Push it into the slot on the right side, and the tray should pop out. All you need to do is drop your Nano SIM in the tray and slot it back into the iPhone. Now it's time to set it up and activate. Hold the power button on top of the phone for a few seconds until it boots up. First step is to pick the language, which is pretty straightforward. Same goes for your country. To activate, you'll either need to connect to Wi-Fi or use the cellular connection, but it's best to use Wi-Fi. Connect to your network and then the phone will activate itself. This can take anything from a few seconds to a few minutes. Next up, we have location services, which uses GPS to tag photos and let apps find you, so enable this unless you would prefer it off. It will ask you to set up as a new phone or restore from a backup. If you're upgrading from an older iPhone, feel free to restore, but if not, just set up as new. Moving on, it will ask you to create an Apple ID. This is the account used with iPods, iPads, and iTunes. Odds are you already have one, so log in or create a new Apple ID if not. Agree to the fine print and it will get everything set up. Now you have the option to use iCloud. This will back up data like photos, contacts, and more, and can be quite useful, but of course you can skip it if you like. If you enable iCloud, you can back up your phone to iCloud automatically, or just use iTunes on your computer. Next, we have Find My iPhone, which will help you find your phone if it's lost or stolen. The iPhone 5 uses email addresses to allow people to contact you with iMessages and FaceTime, so here you can choose which you want to use. It will also ask you if you want to use Siri or not, so go ahead and turn it on as it can be quite helpful. Lastly, we have Diagnostics, which will send usage data to Apple. Nicely done, you have your iPhone 5 set up. Try making a test call. It should work. However, if it doesn't, your carrier might have additional steps, such as calling a number to finish activating. If you found this helpful, don't forget to leave this video a thumbs up. And if you're interested in more iPhone 5 videos, be sure to subscribe.